In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Christ is risen. Christ is risen. Christo auca. We're so blessed to be in the church on the resurrection season. We're in the fifth Sunday, where the Thursday coming is another feast. Do you know what feast it's coming on Thursday?
Ascension.
The Feast of Ascension. Very good. So today, Feast of Ascension, Jesus went where?
Heaven.
So today, God is preparing us about what? Heaven. It's pretty clear, right? Our church is really wise. The Sunday before the Ascension, everything is focused on heaven, heaven, heaven. And you probably think to yourself, what is heaven? Where? How can I get there? But maybe because I sin too much, I'll never get there. Or, that's easy to get into heaven. I'm just going to do some right things here and there and repent and I'll be in heaven. Everyone has their own aspect of how to get to heaven, and I'll try to help you a little bit more today. And of course, our Lord Jesus Christ is so sweet today. He says something nice in verse 3, John 14, 3. Let's turn our Bibles there. Even in the back of the church, please, let's be paying attention here. I know we like singing, but we also have to get into the Word of God. Okay, the Word of God is very important to us. So let's open up to John 14, verse 3. John 14, altogether, verse 3. And our Lord is so sweet that He does promise us heaven. But the way He says it is also very sweet. The part where it says, where I am, this is Jesus talking, where I am, there, what? You may be also. Isn't that so sweet? Like He said, you know what He's saying? Wherever I go, I need you to be with me. If I'm going to heaven, if I'm ascending to heaven, I need you to be with me. Because where I am, you will be also. That's our Lord Jesus Christ. He doesn't want heaven without us. There's even a song that says, He came down from heaven because He didn't want heaven without us. And that's the truth. He's where He is, that's where He wants us to be. That's verse 3. Where I am, there you may be also. He doesn't want us to be without Him. And some of us think, okay, maybe I sin too much. There's no way. Abuna, do you know my sins? There's no way I'm going to heaven. And some of us, like I said earlier, heaven. I'm just going to do a few things that I like to do, and then I'm going to repent and confess to Abuna, and I'll be in heaven. It's no problem. I think we have the wrong concept. But just know one thing. Our Lord will do anything to make sure we're with Him. In some of the church icons for the judgment day, you know what judgment day is, right? When Jesus what? He comes again. He already came, right? He's going to come for the second coming. And that time, there's no more. That's it. He's not going to come and He's not going to like stay on earth for many years. No. He's going to come and there's a judgment day. Well, the icon on the judgment day has Jesus like on His like coming, and then He has this river of fire coming down the middle. And then like the righteous people, and then on the other side, what? The not so good people, right? In our mind, right? We see these people here and these people here. And this river of fire. What is this river of fire? This fire. Most people think the fire is what? When you do something wrong, it says in the book of Revelation, you'll go into the lake of what?
Fire.
Lake of fire. So we know that hell is a bunch of fire, right? Okay? But I want to tell you what heaven is, and maybe you'll understand what hell is. This river that's leading to Jesus is what? A river of fire of love. It's God's love. And those who accept it, those who enjoy a love relationship with Jesus will be with Him. Those who reject it, what? Will reject His love. It's easy as that. Heaven is accepting Jesus' love. What's hell? Rejecting, right? Jesus' love. And we can tell clearly in Hebrews 12. Turn with me to your Bibles. Hebrews 12, 29. You know this because some of you sing this song. Hebrews 12. Open together. Hebrews 12, 29. It says, God's love is a what? Consuming fire. Oh, so now we get it, right? So that lake of fire is what? His love. It's clear in the Bible. The lake of fire, when you do bad things, when you sin, you'll be thrown in there because God hates you and He'll punish you. No. That fire is His love. If you abide in that love, if you accept that love, if you have a love relationship with Jesus, guess what? You're going to be okay. Now, that's Hebrews 12:29. God's love is a consuming fire. St. John the Latter even says, love is the source of the fire. So we have the wrong idea about heaven and hell. You do good things, if they're more than the bad things, you go heaven. If you have bad things more than the good things, you go into the fire. No, the fire is love. If you have a love relationship with God and you accept that love relationship with God, and He loves you and you accept it and you obey Him and you follow Him, guess what? That fire is His love. It's not going to burn you. But if you reject His love, of course, rejection of love is hell. Acceptance of His love is heaven. So that's where we need to go today. That's what heaven is. And you can have heaven now. It's not you have to go to a place. Heaven is now when you abide in God's love. So number one, we have to say it all together. Number one, heaven is abiding in God's love. Number one is what? Heaven is abiding in God's love. And I'm going to explain that. Let's open up our... You want to know what abiding means? Now some people say, what does abiding mean? What do you mean abiding in God's love? Well, I'm glad you asked. Thanks. So John 15, let's go to John 15 verse 10. John 15 verse 10 explains more about this abiding in God's love, because this fire is love. Jesus, when He comes again, wants to give us love. He wants to unite us to His love. So we have to abide in that. If we reject that, we put ourselves in hell. God is not going to put us in hell, by the way. We put ourselves. He's our Father. He's our bridegroom. He loves us, and He's going to pour that fire of love, the consuming fire on us. If we accept that, then we're in heaven. Now look what it says in John 15, verse 10. If you keep My commandments, you will what? Abide in My love. Do you guys get it now? So how do we abide in God's love? You keep My commandments. Let's keep going. Just as I have kept My Father's commandments and abide in His love. The way to abide in Jesus' love is to obey what He's saying. And you know what? You know what's hard for human beings? Is to obey. If someone tells you, if someone tells you what to do, don't you have something inside of you that wants to do the opposite? You know what I'm saying? Someone said, do that. And inside of you said, because you said that, I'm going to do the opposite. We have something in us that we need to ask God's help with this. When He says something, He says, be holy. He says, forgive. He says, be holy, be pure, be whatever. Whatever He says, do it. Because that's how you show that you abide in God's love. So abiding God's love here is what? If you keep My commandments, you will abide in My love. Number one, heaven is abiding in God's love. That's what the fire is, love. It's clear. If you don't believe that one, turn with me to 1 John, the epistle. 1 John 3:14. Everyone turn together to your Bibles. 1 John 3:14. I'm watching. I see somebody not moving. 1 John 3:14. If you don't have Bibles, we sell them in the bookstore. I have some in my office. 1 John 3:14. And I'm sure you have a phone that has a Bible, as we always like to play on our phones. 1 John 3:14 says, we know, listen to this, we know that we passed from death to what? To life, because we love the brethren. He who does not love his brother abides in what? In death. So, if you want heaven, you want life, we must obey what He says. We must love each other. When you love each other, you love Him. When you love Him, that's heaven. By the way, it's that simple. I know you guys say, well, that's not hard. I can do that. Hey, if you can do what He says, keep His commandments, and love your brethren, you pass from death to life. From hell to what? From hell to what? Heaven. You can have, and I can have, heaven now, right now. Okay, we have the mistake that they're, oh, when I die one day. No, you enjoy heaven now, because heaven now is abiding in God's love. Heaven now is keeping His commandments. Heaven now is accepting and loving your brother and sister. Those, St. Isaac the Syrian says, those who are suffering from hell are those being scourged by love. Let me explain what that means. That love of God, He loves us and we reject it. It's scourging us. It's crucifying us. It's stabbing us. Because we're doing wrong things, guess what happens? You feel like, you feel bad. Do you ever feel like no peace in your heart? Like something is wrong? That's God's love trying to penetrate. And we think, oh, I'm having a bad day. No, God is trying to get in. God is scourging us. God is trying to get in. He said, I want to be with you. I want you to have heaven now. And we're kind of like, no, no, no. I don't need that. I want to do whatever I want. Guys, this is a day today. I'm asking you, this is a day today. If God is trying to penetrate your heart with His love, accept it, obey it, live it, enjoy it. It's enough. Outside has already killed us too much. Now God today says, I want to give you heaven. That's what He's saying. Wherever I am, I want you to be. Imagine Jesus saying, hey, if I go here, I want you with me. If I go there, I want you with me. That's how Jesus loves us so much. Do you accept? Abiding is accepting, obeying. Do you accept today to abide in God's love or not? You know, sometimes people focus on hell as a place. Hell is a condition. You know what condition? When you reject God's love. I'll give you an example. How many of you know, raise your hand, the lost son, the prodigal son story? How many of you know that story, the lost son? Okay, you know about the lost son when he came back, right? You know that. Do you know about the older brother, what he did when his brother came back? What did he do? Was he jumping for joy? Woo! My brother is back. This is the best day ever. Is that what he did? What did he do? He was angry. He was bitter. He was in a state of hell. He rejected God's love because the father was accepting the son, the lost son, back. He didn't like that. He rejected it. He was in a condition, in the state of hell. That's what I want to tell you. We always say hell is a place down there full of fire, going to kill us when we make sins. No, hell is a rejection of God's love. It's a condition right now. You can be in hell right now. You can be in hell right now if you don't accept this beautiful love God wants to give you. God wants to penetrate your heart. Do you say yes or no? God, come in or not? Or you can say, no, I don't have time right now. I'm busy. I don't have time to have a relationship with you, God. I'm busy. Abide in God's love, heaven. Reject God's love, hell. You can be now on earth and be in the state of hell, like the story of the elder son who couldn't stand that his brother was getting a robe, a fatted calf, a ring, good sandals. He couldn't stand it. It put him in, you know, when we're jealous of each other, you know, when you're jealous of somebody, you're in a state of hell, right? When you're angry and bitter, you're in the state of hell. Is anybody in the state of hell? But we have a chance today. Say, God, I don't care about those things. I just want your love. I want to obey your commandments, and I want to enjoy and abide in your love. That is heaven. So number one, heaven is what? Altogether, heaven is what? Abiding in God's love. I want to give you number two. Heaven is union with God. Heaven is union with God. Saint Irenaeus says, separation from God is death, and separation from light is darkness. What is separation from God? It's what? Death. And separation from light is what? Darkness. Heaven and hell, to be honest with you, is a state of union with God or separation from God. Let me ask you a question, and you know the answer. What separates us from God? Yeah, our sin, our choices, like I heard behind me here, our choices. Do you know that? You know, God's light is always shining. Let me ask you a question. When you do something wrong, does God turn off the light for you? Answer the question. If you kill someone today, does God stop shining His light? No. It's the other way around. We close our eyes to His what? To His light. Isn't that crazy? So heaven is abiding in God's love. And heaven, number two, is union with God. And it's our choice. It's our choice. If you want to keep doing sin and I want to keep doing sin, we separate. Right? But the light and the love and heaven is always on us. It's up to us to say, yes, I want it, or no, I don't. If we decide to keep our sins, we close our eyes to His light, His love. That's our problem, not His. I promise you guys, God will never, ever stop loving us. He will never stop shining His light on us. It's our choice. Heaven and hell has nothing to do with God. What He wants is what you want. Isn't that crazy? We picture God up there with a big staff saying, punish hell. Heaven, hell. No. He's not doing that. Who told you that? No, it's us who say, we want this fire of love. I want to be united with you, or I reject you. I want to keep your commandments, or I don't. I want to love my brother, or I don't. I want to stop my jealousy and all those dishonest things, those lustful things, or not. It's up to us. It's a choice that we have to make. Number one, heaven is what? Altogether. No. Come on, guys. There's less of us, it means we have to have more power, right? When there was more of us, we need less power. Now, there's less of us, we can have more power, right? Heaven is what? Number two, heaven is? Union with God. We messed up, let's do it again. Number one, heaven is? Number two, heaven is? Look, guys, remember what Jesus said. Where I am, you have to be. He's going to do whatever it takes to put us with him in this heaven, this condition of heaven, this place of heaven. But it's our choice. I want to say something I just said a few minutes ago, but I want to read it again from here. It says, heaven or hell doesn't depend on God. It depends on us. I want us to hear that clearly. Heaven or hell doesn't depend on God. It depends on us. Isn't that crazy? Did you ever think like that? That it's not God going to take you out of heaven, it's you who are going to reject heaven, right? When we reject God's love, we reject union with him, we reject him and reject heaven, right? What we do in church today, by the way, if you know clearly what we're doing today, is we're coming and being in union with God. If anybody knows what we're doing on the communion table, you know that's union with God, right? And some of us here in the church have been rejecting that for years and months and many weeks. Do what you can to be in union with God. You know, union with God is union with his word. Union with God is union with the sacraments. Union with God is how to love each other. Union with God is that you know how to start to be honest now. Because you know, dishonest separates me. Examine your life as I examine my life. I know some of us, when we get out of the church today, we insult each other. How many of us insult each other? You're not insulting a person. You're insulting who? Say it. You're not insulting that person. If I come and insult David today, I'm not insulting David. I'm insulting who? I'm insulting Jesus. When you insult someone today and you hurt someone today, you're not insulting that person. Remember that you're insulting him and separating from him, and you're dividing yourself from being united with him. And that means we can't be abiding in God's love, because remember, abiding God's love is when you love love the brethren. You go from death to life when you love one another. So when you leave here today, some of us have a natural habit to be negative and to be criticizing and to be insulting and to be dishonest and to be selfish. And I'm not saying that like to hurt your feelings, because I know I have those things also in me. I know I have them in me. But what I'm saying is we are putting ourselves in a state of hell, not God. But today I believe in the church today, as we unite with him in the Holy Communion, I believe all of us will be restored to abiding in God's love, to be in union with him again, and to restore our heaven again. Heaven is now. Heaven is now. Let me explain. When Jesus said, where I am, you will be also, right? If that's true, if Jesus is on the table, then that's heaven. Isn't that true? Because he said, where I am, you will be also. If he is here and heaven is, that means heaven is here. Where Jesus is where heaven is. If you want to be with him, welcome today. But also, where love is where he is. Because remember, God is love, right? Now, if we keep hurting each other, we separate ourselves from God and his love. So today, I believe this is a day of union again. This is a day of abiding in him again. This is a day we return heaven to him and to ourselves again. Last thing, we know number one, as abiding in heaven is abiding in God's love. Number two, union with God. And we talked about those things. But number three, which may be one of the most important, is we must desire heaven. Desire it. And I'm going to tell you, desire is a really strong word. If you open your Bibles quickly to 2 Corinthians chapter 5. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 1 and 2. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Turn with me, guys. Everyone turn their Bibles together. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 1 and 2. Listen carefully. You must desire heaven. You must be eager for heaven. You must search for it. It's not going to come to you. You must search for that lifestyle. It says here, 2 Corinthians 5 says, we are earnestly desiring to be clothed with our habitation, which is from heaven. You guys get that? We are earnestly desiring to be clothed with our habitation, which is from heaven. You know what that means? I want to be clothed with heaven now. Yeah, we want nice clothes. Everyone, when you came to church today, right? You woke up in the morning, you're thinking about what? Hey, which clothes should I wear for church today? You gotta look nice, right? It's church, Sunday church. And when I was looking through my galabeas, my black robes, I was saying, which one is good for church today, right? I want to wear the nice one. No, that one's too old. Let me get this one here. It's nicer, right? We always try to find the clothes that make us look nice. But we need to do that for heaven. We must earnestly desire to be clothed with heaven. And even Saint Gregory of Nazianzus said something really awesome. He said, I can't bear any eagerness so intense but go to heaven. He's saying that there's nothing more intense and more that I desire but to go to heaven. That's, look at the mentality. There's nothing else that I desire more intensely and more eagerly than to go to heaven. Can you say that? Or heaven, do you ever think about heaven? Do you ever desire to be there in that condition of heaven? Or is it just kind of like, oh, one day, God willing, if I do good things, if I can change my life, one day I can be in heaven. No. Heaven is now when you abide in God's love. Heaven is now when you're in union with God. Heaven is something to be desired. Do you desire it? Do you desire it? Do you want it? Do you eagerly look for it? I can't bear anything so intense but to go to heaven. When you had the 10 virgins in the story, you can see some of the virgins were eagerly waiting to go to heaven. Right? They were ready with their candles, with their oil. They were eagerly waiting. I wonder if we're eagerly waiting and desiring to rush to church. I wonder if we desire to read His Word. I wonder if anybody desires to take Holy Communion, or it's just kind of a ritual, a tradition. No. Some people around the world, guys, their churches are just opening up, and they can only have like 10 people in the church, and some people still haven't opened up, and people are crying just to be in union with God and take communion. And we, who set up a good system for you all week, and then we come to church today, and then maybe 50% of you will take Holy Communion. Isn't that weird? Don't you desire to be in heaven? This heaven, right? And then we leave here today, we start insulting, and we start going back to our old habits. Don't you desire with all your heart, all your life, to be in heaven? Desire it. Pray for it. Run to prayers. Run to church things. Run to the sacraments. Run to your Bible. Don't run to the bar. Don't run to the sinful things. Don't run to the bad things on social media. Don't run for those things anymore. Enough. Put your phones away sometimes and run to God. He loves you. He's waiting for you. Heaven, He'll never reject you from heaven. He'll never say no to you for heaven. You and me will say no to Him. Isn't that crazy? He'll never say no to you to be, because He said, where I am, you will be also. That's the God that we follow. Number one, heaven is what? Altogether. Heaven is? Number two, heaven is? And three, we have to desire what? Heaven. We must, number three is what? We must?
Desire.
Do you desire heaven? Last thing I'll say is, you know, in the story in the Bible, when Jacob had a dream of the ladder, Saint Jerome says, you know what that ladder is? So when Jacob was laying his head on the rock, there's a ladder that went to heaven, and he saw angels going up and down the ladder to heaven. And Saint Jerome said something nice. He said, Christian life is that we desire to go up that ladder. And guess what he said? He said, on the top of that ladder is who? Who's on the top of that ladder? It's God. Doing what? Reaching His hand to us to take us into heaven. So what I'm saying to you is, Jacob's ladder is a ladder to heaven. Who's on the top of that ladder? God saying, I need you in heaven with me. It's up to us to climb the ladder. Will you climb the ladder today? Jesus is reaching for you. Will you reach out for Him? Will you reach out and say, God, I'm ready to obey you. I'm ready to say my life that I'm doing is miserable. I'm ready to put my hand out to you. How many of you are ready to raise your hand to Jesus? His hand is there. How many of you are ready for that today? You have to be ready. Good. At least 10 of you. The 10 of you who is ready to reach out your hand to Jesus, please make sure that you abide in His commandments, that you participate in the communion, that when you leave here today, please remove the dishonesty. Remove the places and the friends that are killing you. But I'm telling you right now, heaven is abiding in God's love. Heaven is union with God. I pray you desire with all your heart to be with Him. Enjoy heaven now. Your God is reaching His hand to you. Remember when St. Peter was drowning in the water? What did Jesus do? He started laughing at him. He said, sorry, you did a mistake. You did a mistake, go down into the water. Did Jesus do that? No, when he made a mistake, what did he do? He reached his hand to St. Peter and lifted him up. That same hand is lifting you and me up today. That same hand is reaching from Jacob's ladder from heaven to you and to me. Today, heaven can be ours. Right now, heaven can be ours. If you accept God's love, you abide in God's love. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you want to abide in my love, keep the commandments. Union with God is so easy, right here on the table today. Will you accept or reject? Most of you are listening with one ear and out the other ear and say, I'm not ready. When are you going to be ready? When are you going to be ready for heaven? And when you leave here today, please desire the spiritual things, the heavenly things. Desire heaven. Like St. Gregory said, I have nothing more eager in my heart to do but to desire heaven. That's the most important thing for me. I hope it's the most important thing for you and me. Today, we are on our way to the Feast of Ascension. Jesus said, I want you to be with me in heaven. On Thursday, he will go. But wherever Jesus is heaven. I pray you and me can have a relationship with the living God. Abide in his love, union with him, desire it. He's reaching our hand today. It's our choice. State of hell is up to us. State of heaven, it's up to us. I pray you and me can make a right decision today. And when I close and say glory be to God forever, amen, I want you to do this. Sign the cross and say it's time to begin. Okay, when I say glory be to God forever, amen, you say, you make the sign of the cross. You say, let it begin. I'm ready for that journey. Okay? God bless you. Pray for me. I'm praying for you. And glory be to God forever, amen. It's let it begin. Thank you very much.